We are in Sudbury today to celebrate the announcement of the Ontario Satellite Internet Program, a program that the Ministry of Infrastructure tasked IO with delivering, dating back about a year now. It's a part of the almost $4 billion worth of investments that the government of Ontario is making in connecting everybody to 5010 high-speed internet in the province of Ontario by the end of 2025. After a thoughtful, competitive, fair, and transparent procurement, we're here to announce that SpaceX has been selected to be our service provider to do just that.
We knew there were going to be parts of the province that due to their geography, the topography, they're just really challenging areas and prohibitively expensive areas to serve through fixed wired or fixed wireless service. So really this started years ago where we were developing what success would look like in terms of bringing satellite service to the people of Ontario. So Infrastructure Ontario worked very closely with the satellite market, the internet service provider market, to curate an offering that was viable commercially and technically for the market to deliver. We ran a two-staged procurement process, which brought competitive tension to ensure that we got the best pricing and the best outcomes in contract for the people of Ontario. And it resulted in what was announced by government earlier this fall, which is a deal with Starlink, SpaceX, to deliver the service to, again, those people in Ontario who haven't had access to a minimum quality of internet service to date.
A key part of the contract was securing province-wide capacity reservation across all latitude bands in Ontario, essentially ensuring that Ontarians receive priority access to SpaceX services irrespective of subscriber growth. Through this competitive process, we've also introduced a new requirement for Indigenous engagement and participation plan to ensure unique needs of communities are considered.
And the intent of that program really is to drive two outcomes. One is to ensure that meaningful engagement is occurring with Indigenous communities in which the province is funding and building major infrastructure. The second is we want to look to provide socioeconomic development opportunities to these communities as well.
The Indigenous Engagement and Participation Plan sets a precedent for all our procurement processes and establishes new standards for projects. Potential partners will need to ensure meaningful engagement with Indigenous communities, promote sustainability, and maximize Indigenous participation wherever possible.
It really is quite an amazing sight to behold and quite an incredible accomplishment for us to consider. Part of the reason why Infrastructure Ontario, I think, is so instrumental in the space that we inhabit is we are able to identify complex public policy problems that often require a commercial solution. And this is yet another example of that. And not only are we solving this complex public policy problem in a way that is commercially sophisticated and ensures the right outcomes for Ontarians, but when we think about and bring it back to the public impact that we want to have, it's quite amazing to think about the fact that now there are going to be people in the north and other rural parts of the province that are going to be able to do the types of things that us in the south have taken for granted over the last number of years.